Let's balance the equation Na plus H2O yields NaOH plus H2. This is sodium metal plus water. We get sodium hydroxide and hydrogen gas here. We'll also look at the type of reaction and write the states. Let's start with the type of reaction. We have the sodium here. It's coming in and it's pushing the hydrogen out from the water. So now we just have hydrogen atoms over here. The sodium, though, that's with the OH from the water. So we have a single displacement reaction. This is also considered a redox reaction because the sodium and the hydrogen changes oxidation states as well. Let's balance the equation. We have one sodium, two waters, and one oxygen in the reactants. And then in the products, we have one sodium here. We have one hydrogen, but don't forget we have two hydrogens out here. You need to count those. And then we have just the one oxygen atom. Looks like we need to balance the hydrogens here. We have three in the products, two in the reactants. Probably the easiest way to do this is to put a 2 in front of the sodium hydroxide so we can get an even number on this side here. This 2, it applies to everything here. So let's update these numbers. So you have 1 times 2, 2 sodium atoms, 1 times 2, 2 of the oxygen atoms, and then hydrogen, you have 1 times 2 plus these 2 out here. So now we have 4 hydrogens. If we put a 2 in front of the H2O, we have 1 times 2 for the oxygen atoms, so those are balanced. 2 times 2 for the hydrogens gives us 4. We also need to balance the sodium here, so we'll put a 2 in front of the Na, 1 times 2, that gives us 2 sodium atoms. If you wanted to write the states, they'd look like this. This is a very exothermic reaction. There's a link to a video at the end where you can see sodium being placed in water. It's quite spectacular. This is Dr. B with the balanced equation for Na plus H2O, sodium plus water. Thanks for watching.